Lower limb dystonia is dystonia affecting one or two legs. It usually starts in one leg, and then there are several possibilities regarding the progression of dystonia. If the onset is in childhood, dystonia starts on one leg and might spread to other body districts, and children may develop generalized dystonia. However, there are also children that have lower limb dystonia, and this dystonia responds to levodopa. This is dopa-responsive dystonia. It responds very well to a medication named levodopa, and it often stays localized in the leg. If the onset is later on, in early adulthood, in the 20s or the 30s, dystonia with onset in the lower limbs can be also an onset symptom of young onset Parkinson's disease, especially in a genetic Parkinson's disease type, which is called Parkinson's disease. Those subjects have a genetic mutation for the Parkinson's gene. But also other types of young onset Parkinson's disease can have lower limb dystonia as a frequent symptoms. It shouldn't be forgotten that also when dystonia starts in the lower limb in adulthood and is often fixed, can be functional dystonia, which is a totally different type of dystonia with different treatments and different progression. And often this type of dystonia is not properly recognized. Dystonia can be also a symptom of Parkinson's disease during the progression of Parkinson's disease. Again, it often affects the leg, the foot especially, and determine very painful dystonic contraction, especially in the morning before the medication are taken or when the medication of Parkinson's disease wear off. We treat this type of dystonia with botulinum toxin, but also we treat this type of dystonia trying to improve and to optimize the medical treatment of Parkinson's disease. When dystonia in Parkinson is very severe, maybe one of those symptoms leading to deep brain stimulation for Parkinson's disease and is effectively treated by this procedure.